How are you, Professor? So nice to see you after such a while.
Oh well, I feel happy that I get to see your channel. If you see you.
One of the reasons I wanted to speak to you is because you understand finances of poor people and the impact of poverty on women. So I wanted to get a sense from you on how is this COVID crisis and the ensuing economic crisis going to affect the poor, their availability of credit, and women among the poor. What are your thoughts and how should we think about this going forward?
Yeah, it's the same old story. It's not new that I've been raising this issue. The financial system is designed in a very wrong way. So coronavirus, what it has done is reveal the weaknesses of the society in a very ugly way that you can see it now. These are hidden away into the society. We got used to it. It's there. The poor people are there. Migrant workers are in the city. They are hiding in the city. We have our people working for us, cooking food for us. They're a security person for us, darwan for us. They're taking care of our children. We knew them. But suddenly we see millions of them on the highway trying to go home. It's revealed that suddenly all the city migrant workers are coming out of the city and in a big crowd and going out. For a simple reason, they have nothing here. They have no life here because no money here to survive. So the ultimate place they can go back to is their home. So they desperately they are going home. And then on foot, 1,000-mile journey. That's the saddest part of the whole thing. That's what the coronavirus has revealed us. So we have to recognize these people. The economics doesn't recognize these people. They call it informal sector. Yeah. Informal sector means we have nothing to do with them. They are not part of the economy. Economy begins with the formal sector. We are busy with the formal sector. If we can only finance them, we can take care of them, pay attention to them, they will be moving up the ladder because they have the basic ingredients of them. And they know how to fight for their life and they know how to make it happen. But we ignore them. And comes the women. Women is the remotest of all. This, if you're looking at the structure, this is the lowest structure. They have no voice, nothing in the society and our traditions make them completely separate from them. They are the basic strength of the society. All the entrepreneurial ability, when microcredit came, when it went to the women, they showed how much entrepreneurial capacity they had. And that's why the microcredit known for the whole world, not just Bangladesh and India, it's the whole world, because they have shown their work. They can fight, they know, they have the skill, they have the artisanal skills of all kinds, beautiful skills. And they are all forgotten because they belong to the what we call informal sector.
The tragedy, of course, is that countries like Bangladesh, countries like India, these are the biggest assets. These micro entrepreneurs, they are the future. They're where the money is going to be. There's where the growth is going to be. But for some reason, the system is not interested in looking at them at all. They just because they don't exist.
Absolutely. We follow the Western way of doing things in the financial system and the economic system. So we didn't think about the vibrant capacity of the people, countries like India, Bangladesh, and Indonesia. They have the tremendous tenacity to do things and make things happen, very creative way. That creativity has to be admired and supported. But government has stayed away. It's an informal sector. You have nothing to do. Rural economy has become an appendix to the urban economy. Again, a traditional Western way of looking at the economy. It's the hub of activities. And the rural economy is the supplier of the labor. It's the labor-producing factory. Hmm. And they will be sending to their people to the cities to find a job. If you don't find a job, you'll have a bad luck. And you rot there inside the city. Why can't we have the economy of the rural area built as a separate parallel economy, autonomous economy, rather than have an appendix like that? Today, the situation has changed than what 100 years back. Technology has given us the facility which never existed before. Cities were important because it has the infrastructure. Rural areas didn't have the infrastructure. Today, infrastructure is not limited to urban areas. You have the telecommunication, you have the road, you have the transportations, you have the communications, everything is there. So what is it that you have to go to the city to? Why can't we create an economy? People can live where they are born and have a livelihood, basic livelihood right there.